कनेक्ट आउट कर दो मैम,
सर प्लीज सर
कनेक्ट आउट
प्लीज
कर
सर,
दो मैम,
आई विल बी देयर वन मिनट।
वॉइस कर दो, वॉइस साउंड कर दो।
हाँ गुड मॉर्निंग सर, गुड मॉर्निंग, फाइन फाइन फाइन, हाँ फाइन। No, other day, all the things, all the requests are to be placed before evaluation committee. That committee meeting is scheduled only in the month of March, March or March middle or March end. So therefore, your request also will be considered there. Now your chapter is to be there by March 9th. Consent also we March, your chapter is suggesting that March 7th. Now I may have to it is a special approval and I have conducted the inspection and I have given it. You call me on 11th or 12th, because by the time I will be able to make backup. 11th of 11th, because our director above me is also not in station to give you a direct word right now. Okay, 11th or 12th, you give me a call and I will be able to tell you what I have.
हेलो
फॉर्म पनिया अदर मेंबर्स की
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल आर रिक्वेस्टेड प्लीज म्यूट योर माइक and we will start the session in next 5 minutes.
Okay. And then we'll mute our mic. Yeah.
throughout India.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Institute Innovative Council la thodukanga sir na irukki.
Institute?
Innovative Council.
Oh, all India la undu na?
Avan sir mottham throughout kada adi. Unna sir dikkat sir adi.
Chudan madam na pair enter chesina na mail enter chesante povatle.
Enduku ippudi naaku okuna illa. స్టార్ట్ వీడియోనా వద్దు మ్యూట్ లో జస్ట్ దీంతో కదా ఓపెన్ చేశారు మీరు గూగుల్ క్రోమ్ తో కానీ ఏం వినిపించడం లేదే
Very good morning. Thank you for joining today's session on demonstration of data submission portal of ARIA 2021. And also we will have one question and answer session after the demonstration. And we have planned this second round of orientation session for on category wise and this first session is for focusing for the two categories. The first category is called centrally funded technical institutions, central universities, and institute of national importance. Also, the universities of government and government aided. It may be a state-run university or a centrally supported university. So we have planned this category wise sessions because maybe the questions will be a bit different from the category to category, and also not to make too crowd this kind of sessions. That's why we planned to organize separately. And let me brief you that what is the progress so far. We have received more than 150 institutions for this particular categories, more than 70 institutions from the centrally funded technical institutions. That includes all IITs, NITs, and IIMs, and also central universities, ISERs, and from the state, from the university category also, we have received more than 84 universities. The government and government aided universities, they are participating in this ARIA 2021, and we are expecting this number will goes up from so another 50 or 60 or 100 institutions will join very soon in these categories. So this year the competition will be a bit tough because we have started in 2019 and this is the third edition of ARIA. But in this last two editions, the acceptance rate among the institution has been increased and doubled. And now, if you will see the total number of participation of government institution during 2019 is less than 50 or maximum less than 100. But this year, it is going more than 200. So it is increasing, and this is a good sign that institutes are taking the innovation and startup very seriously, and also they are trying to understand that how this innovation and startups actually helping helping the institutions not only establish them as one of the premier institute, also it helps the students to develop the quality of innovativeness and entrepreneurial. And which is very, very essential for not only for the economy, also for the personal at the wealth creation. And this Atal ranking is also providing a guidance and directional support with a measurable indicators for institutions to know that what is actually a one innovation and startup ecosystem in higher education institutions, and how, what is the different components and in which component they are good, in which component they are strong, in which component they are weak, and also they can make a kind of a analysis of that that what kind of efforts and plans they need to put so that they will improvise the ecosystem and also will come up with a very vibrant and dynamic startup and innovation ecosystem in the campus. So this is the overall objective of ARIA when we started 2 years back, and the Ministry of Education is aiming that in next 2 to 3 years, almost all major higher educational institutions, be it a private or a government, they should be the part of this hotel ranking system. And this innovation ranking is also going to help government to plan various programs and also linking this kind of hotel ranking scores with funding schemes and also innovation schemes to identify the potential beneficiaries, and which will ensure proper utilization of the fund and proper utilization of the fund that for the institutions. Now coming to the today's session, because we started 2 months back, and many institutions, they have registered, also completed the pre-qualifier section, but still there are institutions, those have not completed the pre-qualifier section. So please complete the pre-qualifier section, which is essential steps to get into the data submission portal. And pre-qualifier section will not take more than 1 hour if you will give the time, because in the pre-qualifier section, you need not to provide any data or kind of things. Also, only you have to list out the departments, units, centers, bodies or the organizations exist within the ecosystem of the institute or in the campus, which contributes to promote and support innovation and startup in the campus. So there you have to list out all academic departments, all research departments, all the units and incubation and the pre-incubation units. Those are operating within the campus. So in the pre-qualifier, you don't list these things. And before that also, what this year in this ARIA 2021, because we have already introduced these 5 categories of institution in the last year itself, but we observed that there are many institutions, those are not technical in nature, and they are not able to participate in this hotel ranking. That's why in this ARIA 2021, we have introduced a classification of the institution under the two major groups. One is technical institutions, another is non-technical institutions. And during the registration time itself, it was provided with a choice that you have to select that is your institute belongs to the technical or non-technical. So it is obvious that if you are running any technical program, that is any engineering, architect, planning, or medical, or kind of things, it's a technical program, then you have to choose technical. You are falling under the technical institution category, though you have other non-technical programs also. But if institution is not running any single program on technical program, then only like arts and science college, MBA and commerce colleges. So those are the standalone and affiliated colleges. Those are not running any other technical programs in the campus, then they have to choose this non-technical category. So this is the way, but we found that there are many institutions, they are not able to decide in which category. That's why they left this choice blank. But in next 20-25 days, we are planning to review all these applications, especially the registration status, to classify them into this technical and non-technical category. And after review, if we found that some institutes they have wrongly placed or they have gone to the other categories, then we will correct it and we will send one notification to the institute to confirm it. So this is the way. And for that also, this pre-qualifier section will also help, because this is the way. And also we will do some due diligence and also check some background data by getting to the institute's web page. And also we will see get the data from UGC and AICT. To ensure that this institute is purely technical purely non-technical, or they're also running in technical programs. And accordingly also, this is the responsibility of your institute to choose the right category. And if you have not done, then don't worry. We are going to do that part. And also we will send the confirmation and the notification to get the kind of a confirmation from your side. So this is the about the classifying into technical and non-technical. Once it is done, then your again the, these five categories, that is centrally funded, then government university, then private university, government college, and the private college. So these five categories will be fit into each classification. But I'm not sure that what is the number of total non-technical institution category will be for this year. So based on the number of counts, either the committee will take the decision that we will go with for publishing the rank for each and every category for the non-technical institution or not. Because this is the first year we are starting this non-technical category, so maybe it will take 1 to 2 years to get familiar among the non-technical institutions. But definitely for technical institution, the already the momentum is up, and more number of technical institutions, they are participating in this thing. So definitely we have this five category, and as per the suggestion from the different like from the president house or from the ministry, we every year we introduce a specific category which will be counted during that time. So in general, these five categories are the standard, but additional specific category that will be announced during the time of ranking when you publish the result. So this is about the classification, technical, non-technical. Then it is the category of the institution. These are the five standard categories. And for non-technical, after review and after getting the submission, committee will decide that how many categories and what is the number of ranks, everything that we are going to publish. So this is all about the, let me share my screen now so that you will able to see that how the data submission portal looks like, because we are, I think you are already in the process of data collection. Also many students have started submitting the data and entering in the portal. So definitely most of you already familiar, and also you are also know the different sections, but still I will demonstrate again today so that the doubts and the queries that you have that will be cleared. Let me share my screen. So the most important information is that the last date for submission of the final data is now 8th of March. It has been extended, and this is also same date for the pre-qualifier section. So if institution has not completed the pre-qualifier section, they can complete the pre-qualifier section, then they will start entering their data and also data collection, data entry, everything. So please ensure that you complete the pre-qualifier section first, then you get into the DCS system for data collection. And if you will see the DCS, how it looks like. So it will ask, I think most of you have the ID, and you can use the your login ID to get into DCS system. And DCS means data capturing system. So this is the portal. Okay, so this looks like this. So once you will get into the DCS, it will first a welcome page will appear, and in this welcome page you will able to see ARIA 2020-21 framework. That you can download that framework. You can see the what are the parameters, what are the score and weightages for each parameter, also the sub parameters. Also in this welcome page, you will able to access the Excel guide for data collection. And in the last 2 months, there were some corrections, there were some improvisation we have made. So you can definitely download the updated version of Excel guide from here. And this Excel guide is exact replication, or it captures the similar the fields present in this DCS system. So I hope you all know about this, and you are making use of this Excel sheet for data collection purpose. And once it is done, then when you collect the data, if you want to enter the data, then you have to click the proceed button. Also, to help you to understand the different parameters section, we have provided the video guides, and here you can watch the video guide for the ARIA 2021, and also in the respective sections also we have provided the video guides for that particular session. So once you click the proceed button, it will take you to the next stage, and the first one is called pre-qualifier, and the second tab is called data submission portal. As I said that so far you will not complete the pre-qualifier, you will not able to get into the data submission portal. It will be inactive stage. So first you have to go to the pre-qualifier, and as I said that this pre-qualifier you have to only provide the information related to what kind of departments, centers, units or facilities that is autonomous, like any like body or organization that is located within the campus, also contributing to the to development of this innovation and startup ecosystem in the institutions. Then you have to provide everything, and you have to click a save and add more for multiple submissions. So once you will start adding the departments and the facilities, then please make sure that you provide the all incubation units or pre-incubation unit, research park, innovation cell, whatever the things which is kind of a entity or a department or center, and these things will display here at the bottom. So once it is done, then only you will get into the data submission portal. So let me get into the data submission portal now. So this is the data submission portal, and once you click this data submission portal, it will display four tabs. The first tab is on it is asking about participation of higher education institutions in innovation and entrepreneurship initiatives of Ministry of Education. So this is a new introduction for this ARIA 2021, because Ministry of Education is running so many innovation and entrepreneurship programs, and if your institute is participating, then you have to give the status of participation in these programs. So it is very simple. Again, here also you will get this manual, user manual video. Also you will access to the Excel sheet that we have placed in this section also. So once you click this tab, it will ask you this 5-6 programs. So and you have to select the status, yes or no. If you will select yes, then it is okay and you have to submit. Like if it is no, then you have to click no and you have to submit. And if you click yes for this IIC, then it will ask you IIC registration ID. So these are the just to capture the status. And at the back end, we have the information which institute has done what, because these are the Ministry of Education's programs. So once you will update the status, and only for this establishment of institutions innovation council program, we are asking the IIC registration ID. But for other programs, we are not asking. We have the information, though we have the information for these IICs, but to ensure proper information to be included, that's why we are asking this IIC registration ID. So these are the 5-6 programs. You have to provide the status, and once you have done, then you can save. Like, let me complete one. So please make sure that you select only correct choice rather than the randomly yes, 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 and like no, because later it will impact during the review time. And once you save it, then get into the next, and here there are three tabs. One is data section, that is non-financial detail. Another is called data sections financial detail. So these two are very important, which is comprising this data DCS system. And why we kept financial part separate, because sometimes when institute they approach to the departments to get the information for that particular parameter, sometimes respective departments are not able to provide the financial details, because it directly linked and this information with this account section. That's why we have created a separate section that is for the financial details. And these details, if nodal officer receive the information from the respective department, it is very good. If not, they can give the access to the account section of the institute so that they will get the information at one go. So this is to ease the process we have separated this financial part from the non-financial detail, but the you have to take precaution that first you have to start with non-financial detail, because in the non-financial detail you have to provide information for all the parameters and sub-parameters. Only when this financial part will come, you have to give the declaration that there is a financial, and it will that particular line item will come and display in financial details. Okay, so once this is done, then once you complete this thing, all this data submission, then the declaration then the declaration and submission is the final stage. So I will, before I get into the declaration and the submission, let me show you the data sections, that is non-financial details. Once you click this data sections non-financial details, it will show 8 sections, and more or less these sections are directly correlated with the parameters and the sub parameters. For example, this section 1, this is on developing innovative and entrepreneurial mindset through activities. This section requests, or the, this section collect the data from the institutions regarding various activities or events related to innovation, entrepreneurship, IPR and startup they have organized during the financial year 2019-20. For this, we have this data is for the financial year, because for conducting the activities, institute required money, or there is a involvement or something requirement of finance to organize this kind of events. So this is a financial year data, and it starts from the April 2019 to till March 2020, March 2020. So similarly, this section 2, it is directly, you can say, it's synonym with the parameter 2. And this section, this is on teaching and learning, and mostly these are the academic programs or extracurricular or in curricular programs. That's why this is for the academic year, and academic year varies from institute to institute. So you have to choose the academic year, you have to select the month and date as per the academic year of your institute. Now comes to the section 3. This is for the dedicated infrastructure and facilities to promote innovation and entrepreneurship. So this is again for the financial year, and this covers data related to innovation, pre-incubation, incubation facilities, and related services and the supports. This section 4, you can say it is a parameter 4, and this is largely on number of innovations, successful innovations from the institutions. So during the financial year 2019-20. Now this section 5 is for the startups or the ventures or the units, SME units. This is again for the financial year 2019-20. And this award, this section 6, it is not a parameter, but this section 6 awards and recognition, this is a list of innovations, startups, or the teams, those have secured awards or recognition while participating in various activities organized by the institute or from the section 4 and section 5. So in section 6, you need not to enter anything. Only what the information you have entered in the section 1, section 4, and section 5, it will display here that if any innovation or the startup team, they have secured any position or they have received any recognition award at the national and international level. So here you have to just check and verify that if it is correct, then you just leave it as it, or you can go back to the respective section to correct if something wrong entry has been made. So this section 6 is not a separate parameter. This is the represent, it is just pulling the information from section 1, section 4, and section 5. Now comes to the section 7. This is parameter 6, and which address the need of the collaboration and investment facilities, that is angel investment or the venture capital facilitations. So this capture the information, and this is again for the collaboration is for the academic years, and this investment, angel investment, is the financial year. And this field or the field will not reflect in the financial section, because the financial part involved or associated with this section are not directly linked with the account section. Because when angel investor or any financial institution, they invest on startup or innovation, they never give money to the institutions. They directly lend the money to startups or innovations. That's why account section have no detail. That's why this money, this detail has to be provided itself. Next comes to the section 8, that is intellectual property generated and commercialized. This is parameter 7, and you have to provide details regarding intellectual properties like copyright and design, patents, all kind of things. Next, I think this is the overall sections. And as I said that this section 1 involves some financial component. This section 3 also having some financial component. Section 4, section 5, and section 8 have some financial component. So when you will start entering the data in these sections, wherever this financial part will come, you have, and if you will declare that there is a financial component is there, then this line item will reflect in the financial section that I have showed earlier here. Here, so you can say these sections, and once you will click, then you will see that list of activities or the list of items where financial value is required. And already we have given one temporary login ID to the nodal officers. They can use the temporary login ID to the financial section, or they can collect the information from the Excel sheet and they can enter here. So both ways they can complete this financial section. Now let's show me very quickly how each section look like and what are the important things you should keep in mind during the data entry. So this section 1, it has again two sub parameters, that is events conducted by the institute, and another is called events where institute has sent the participation in terms of the students or faculties to participate in that program or the competition. And just make sure that all these events and competitions should be related to innovation, entrepreneurship, or IPR or startup related programs. So here you have to provide the detail, and all these things I think are needless to say, because only you to keep two things here. The question is that had institute spent expense either from own resources or received fund, then once you will click yes, you will not able to enter the financial value here, but you have to, once you will click yes, this line item will reflect in the financial section where you have to provide the financial data, that is what is the expense amount. Similarly, if you will click the did any of the participants received any awards, if you will click yes, then you have to provide the value here, and this value will reflect in section 6. As I said that there is awards and recognition section that will reflect that from program conducted, from this events conducted section, and these are the awards received by the students from this institute. And if you found something wrong entry there, then you can again come back to this section and you can make changes, and you have to submit, save again. So once you are done with one activity, for multiple activities you have to click save and add more option. And please make sure that only this, the activities conducted during the financial year 2019-20 has to be provided. And once you complete all the things, you will able to see like this, and you can still manage the things. You can edit it, you can delete it by clicking here, the action buttons. And once you are done with this, then you have to go to the next sub parameter, next tab, and again you have to provide the details. So this is about the, and here you can check the video guide for this section, and also you can if once you are done with the things, you can go back and you can go to the section 2. In section 2, it has three sub tabs and or three sub parameters, and because they are directly correlated with the sub parameters, so you have to provide the information. And here minimum 30 contact hours programs only to be included. So if something is less than 30 hours, you cannot include here. So there are some validations, and both online and offline mode of courses can be included, can be entered. And similarly comes to the employment generation skill development programs. Here also you will get the detail of to provide. And again here also 30 contact hours is minimum. And the third one is called train faculties on innovation and entrepreneurship and IPR. This is a new addition in this new section. And here you have to provide the faculty name and the department or center name, designation. Also, there are two guided questions. Is that faculty on any degree in innovation or in entrepreneurship or IPR? If it is yes, then only it will ask these three questions. If you will click no, it will not, these three questions will disappear. Similarly, if any faculty has received any training on innovation, entrepreneurship or IPR, if you select yes, then only these questions will come. And if that faculty has participated more than one training program, you can add more training program, but it has to be only during this particular academic period. So this is the way you can manage the entry. And please make sure that you enter the faculties, those have either received any training program or have any kind of a degree on innovation, entrepreneurship or IPR. Also, if you wish that any faculty who is associated with or associated for mentoring support, you can enter the name by clicking no and here also no, so that these names, the entered names of faculties will reflect in section 3, where you have to select the mentors who has been associate for mentorship support. So please make sure that all faculties and the faculties those are associate for mentorship enter by clicking no and no here. And if they have received any training or degree, also you can select yes and provide that details. Once you have complete this section, then comes to the section 3. Section 3 has three tabs. The first one is called regarding student clubs, because student clubs are very, very important pillar for driving this campus innovation and startup ecosystem. And most of the IITs and NITs, even deemed universities, also major important institutions, they promote student clubs and student clubs on innovation, student clubs on ideas, student clubs related to the intellectual property. This has to be promoted. And that's why in the first tab, institute has to provide the what are the student clubs, especially in the innovation idea and idea clubs, innovation clubs or startup clubs kind of things they have in the campus. And the second tab is on dedicated facilities for innovation and entrepreneurship and IPR. Here you will get the first. Just wait, because I have some pre-entered things. So when you will open this tab, it will only show you these things. And you have to declare, you have to give a declaration, you have to tick the appropriate option for each one. So just assume that if that institute has pre-incubation facility, which is more than 600 square feet area, floor area, then which is also can be a IEDC cell or EDC cell or innovation cell or startup cell, then once you will click yes, it will show you this detail and you have to provide here. And here, once you will select yes, that they have supported, they have provided funding support to innovations or ideas, then this the name of pre-incubation unit that you have entered will display in the drop-down box in section 4 and section 5. So please make sure that you enter the proper name of pre-incubation unit. This can be multiple pre-incubation units also you can add. Like if one institute has innovation cell, one institute also they have the EDC cell, also they have the startup cell, then you can list out one by one by clicking the save and add more option, and these names will appear in section 4 and section 5 while entering the funding support to innovations and the startups. So once it is done, similarly, this is for the center of excellence with advanced tools and equipments. Once you will click yes, you will get the details. Here also you have to select the options like provided any funding support and also what are the expenses. Once you will click the expenses, it will ask you to what kind of grant or fund they have received this particular incubation unit or respective infrastructure. So grant, you have to select the choice from this drop down. You have to provide the agency name, and if that particular unit has received more grants from more than one agency, and you can use the add more option, and you can provide the all these schemes or the grant agencies provided funding support to the particular unit. So in this way you can manage, and especially the fund part, it will reflect in financial section that as I showed earlier. So this line items will reflect there to provide the financial data. Here you can provide the other details. So this is the way you can manage, and this one is related to revenue. If that particular incubation unit or research park has received any revenue from the startups or the fund innovations to whom they have supported in terms of fee or like a rent or fee or in other ways, then they can check yes and they can provide these details. But again, these are the financial details. It will it has to be entered through the financial section. So this is the way you can give the details. And yes, I forgot to mention this one. This is the last one, enabled mentoring service support. As I said that in the section 2, once you will enter the faculty names, those are associates and provided mentoring support during that particular academic year, and these names will reflect here in the drop down. So I entered my name, that's why it is reflecting my name here. And you cannot enter independently again in this section the faculty name. So first you have to make sure that the faculty name to be entered in that section, in section 2, then only you can able to select the option from the drop down. So this is the more important things, and you have to provide mentorship details. If that mentor has provided mentoring support to startups, then you have to provide the startup details too. And if they have engaged in more than one startup, mentoring support with more than one startup, then you can manage here by using the add more option. Now comes to the section 4. Section 4 and section 5 quite similar, only section 4 is focusing on innovation, whereas section 5 is focusing on startups. And here you have to provide the details, and you have to select the what kind of innovation and what are the type of innovation. Here it is, I think, these are the multi selects. So if any innovation is fitting to the more than one of the innovation criteria, you can select here. And you have to enter the principal innovator, which is compulsory, but co-innovators are not compulsory. You can skip it if there is no co-innovator. And again, you have to select the technology readiness level and what are the current status as of 31st March of 2020, and what are the status of receiving pre-incubation or the incubation support, and all the things. And also you have to give declaration that what kind of is that particular startup or innovation has received any awards at the things. Once you will click yes, then you have to provide the details, and these details will reflect in section 6 of awards and recognition part, and you can cross check also. And similarly, if that particular innovation has converted into any kind of a startup or venture, you can provide by 31st of March 2020. And also these are the things you have to give declaration. So if it is a grant, if kind of any grant amount received by that particular innovation, then this information will reflect in the financial section where you have to enter. And similarly, any seed fund, then if you are clicking that this innovation and startup has received any angel fund or VC fund, then these entries will reflect in section 7. That is section 7 of parameter tab 2, where angel fund and VC fund details to be provided. And this is for the revenue. If that particular innovation or startup has provided, started giving or return back to the incubation unit in terms of the fee, rental fee or other fees, then that way also you have to enter here. So this is for the section 4, and also in every section we have a video guide, you can watch it. And now comes to this section 5, which is exactly similar, but here we are going to this section is going to capture startup related information, because like their establishment date, year of registration, then who is the founder, then other questions like is that startup has gone to a level of generating revenue, and also started generating employment, all kind of things. At the impact level also there is one question, that is more than 10 member of 10 employee or 50 lakhs turnover during the financial 2019-20. So once you click yes, maybe in the review stage we are going to ask the proof, but at this time you can give the you can select the appropriate option for the question at the impact level, impact creation by the startups. And you have to provide the startup DIN number of the founder, then SIN number of the startup, all the things you will provide here. And this is for the section 5. Now comes to this section 6. As I said, that this is the section where the information from section 1, section 4 and section 5, the awards and recognitions received by the startups, innovations and the student teams will be displayed here. So you can check which section has what kind of entries, and if you feel that something is wrong, then you can go back to the respective section and you can correct, and you can save the things so that the correct things will reflect here. Now comes to this section 7. In section 7, it has again two tabs. One is for the angel and VC fund, and one is called collaboration with external agencies and co-creation of innovation entrepreneurship activities. So as I said, that in section 4 and section 5, there is one question, that is that innovation has that innovation received any angel or VC fund or loan or credit from different financial institution. Once you click yes, then this line item will reflect here, and you have to provide the financial value, that investment amount, and also who has provided that investment, and all details you have to provide here. So this is regarding the venture and angel fund details received by the innovations and the startups during this financial year 2019-20. Just note that this value you have to enter in the non-financial section itself. This line items will not display in financial section, as this is not directly related and linked with the account section of the institutions. Now comes to the collaboration with external agencies. Here you have to provide what are the collaborations that institute put, and also they have made with different agencies, and the collaboration may be of different type, like purpose of collaboration. One is either institutes are collaborating with the other institution, also other incubation units, to provide and to receive the incubation and the pre-incubation support, or they are collaborating with other institutions for the handholding and mentoring support on conducting the innovation and entrepreneurship activities, or they are collaborating with the institutions and other agencies for the knowledge exchange and for the internship opportunities in the startups and innovations. So this is the three type of collaborations we are going to measure, and accordingly you have to provide the detail of collaborations conducted or made during that particular period. So this is for the academic year period, and this is the tentative number of beneficiaries during that particular period because of this collaboration. So one question I have received yesterday regarding that, what will happen to the running MOUs. So running MOUs, so here we are capturing that what are the new collaboration and efforts made by the institute. So here only the list of collaborations made during that particular year to be considered. So the beneficiaries created during that particular period. Now comes to the last one, that is called intellectual property. It has six sub tabs, and the first one is research papers on innovation and entrepreneurship published in different Scopus Index and SCI Index journals. These things we will get it from the third party source, And similarly, this is patent published and granted also, we will get it from the third party source. But for the remain four sections, that is IPR filed and published, and this section is only going to capture the copyrights and designs, and another is patents filed, and this is only for the patents. So these two things to be provided by the institute, and this one, this patents held by innovations and startups incubated at pre-incubation and incubation unit, this also institute has to provide, and this is the section where patents held by incubated startups and the incubated innovations to be provided. And the last one is for IP commercialized. So here during this period, especially this is a financial period, because this involves the financial part. So what are the technologies or intellectual property or the IP, maybe it may be copyright, it may be trademark, whatever may be. So what are the intellectual properties, the technologies that has been commercialized and transferred to the industry or the startups for commercialization? So these things has provided, and also institute have to provide the detail of MOU or collaboration or licensing agreements made between the party with a date and documents. So all these things has to be provided. So all this is about the different sections as part of non-financial section. And as I said, that only the financial things will come and reflect. And I hope you all got the sections which is financial components, especially section 1, section 3, section 4, section 5, and section 8 have some financial component. That's why the details will reflect here. And account section can provide the information in this section, so that nodal officer will review it and they will cross-check once before final submission. So now these three things over, and the final is declaration and submission. In declaration and submission, these are the form. As I said, that many institutions, they have skipped this institute type, and also sometimes institute has selected wrong category. So again, we are asking to confirm that what they have selected. So first you have to see that the institute type, that actually you are falling under the technical or non-technical, or in which category of institute you are falling, that is either you are a university or deemed to be university or what. So everything you have to see, cross check, and if you feel that these are not correct, then you can edit here, and after that you have to confirm. So once you will confirm, we will take it grant that you are okay and you are giving consent with these options. And also there is a consent to be obtained for each and every section, that is for pre-qualifier, for all remain 8 sections and parameters. And once you confirm it, like the ticket, then only you will be able to see this last submit button, which will active. If your confirmation part is not complete, and if you have not this red color one is not checked, then you will not able to submit the form. So this red color says that there is some incomplete part. So this red color says that incomplete part, and this button is for the edit the visit the respective section and edit and correct the things. And this section, this confirm column, is for once you edit and correct, then you have to again revisit and you have to confirm. Once it is done, then finally you have to provide the signature of the head of the institute and also head of the also nodal officer, and this will be a joint declaration that whatever you have entered, you have verified, you have cross-checked, and you provide it, because this year this data will reflect in the public, especially all this application detail, and it has to be remain in the public till the result declaration stage. So this year every institute's responsibility is that they will make this PDF, this application detail, the PDF to be prominently displayed in the home page of the institute's web page. And if any query will come from the outsider, they have to reply it back with proper justification. And this result, it has to be remain active in the web page of the institute till the result declaration, even for next some period, even after the result declaration also. So this is all about result declaration. Sorry, this is all about all sections, pre-qualifier and data sections. And you can make use of this Excel sheet. As I said, that this is whatever the fields you have seen, it has been compiled and framed in the Excel sheet. I will show you once that how it looks like. So this. So this is this looks like. So just wait. So this is the home page. You can see that each section, each parameter with all subsections and the parameter sub parameters, and also video guideline also you can watch here, and allocation of weightages, and for any kind of a difficulties you can reach to the technical query for related to the portal or kind of login or something, some error in the reflection of the data in the portal, all kind of things you have to reach to the technical query section. And for specific query, definitely you can reach to me. And we have created one Telegram group also. Through that also we are trying proactively resolve all these queries and also answering. So that please join, all nodal officers are requested to join the Telegram group. And let's see that all institute will work with a common goal, that to make our Indian higher educational institutions innovative, entrepreneurial, and also we will establish a standardized and standardized version of ecosystem which has measurable indicators. And this Excel sheet, you can navigate to the respective page. If you want to navigate to this section one, then you just click there, you can go back. And this way, one some like user-friendly version of Excel format we have developed for to facilitate this data collection process. But it's up to the institution how they are doing this data collection process. So this is all about data submission and pre-qualifier, then data collection process and demonstration of the data submission data capturing system. And I believe most of you have got a clear picture that how this ARIA portal data submission system works. And next 10 to 15 minutes is for the question and answer. So if you have any question, then you have to raise the hand icon in your screen, so that I will open one by one, and I will take the question, and I will take 5 to 6 question, and rest of the things you can ask in the Telegram group also, so that others also will get some solution, and also they will get the information. So I will take one by one. The first one is the Dipaloy Datta. Tithi, are you there? Would you please help me to enable the speaker to ask the question? Tithi? Dipaloy Datta, please enable her to ask the question. Dipaloy Datta, please unmute yourself and you ask your question. Please ask your question.
May I ask you a question?
Yes, yes, please go ahead.
Yes, I am Professor Charumati, heading the Department of Management Studies, and I am also one of the facility, Section 8 company university. And regarding this ranking, you are talking about that one item on the expenditure incurred for innovation related activities like training, capacity building, or mentoring, all those things. So incubation facility is given some money to start that Section 8 company, and we are given some seed capital by the university. Can we show that as a money which is spent for innovation activity as per the format?
No, so you are asking for the Section 3, the dedicated facility creation.
Section 8 company, a special purpose vehicle, which we formed for the startup and innovation.
I got your point, but my question is that is this related to Section 3? Section 3 of dedicated facility creation, where you are saying that for setting up the pre-incubation, these are the supports or what?
Yes, sir. Earlier it was called Section 3. You are asking about the beneficiaries or you are asking about the section?
No, I want to know the section. Which, this question is related to which section?
That is the expenditure part. We can show some expenditure spent for what is the amount spent for innovation activities. There is one section when you are
which section? Please mention the section name and section kind of things. Then only I will be able to answer. Because there are so many questions. For me to remember, you have to raise that which section this question comes from.
Okay, I will go through the format and come back, sir.
Sure.
Others can continue, please.
Yes. Next question. Dipali Dutta ji, please proceed. Please ask your question.
So may I ask, Deepan, behalf of Dipali ji, Dipali is from same organization.
Excuse me?
Yeah, question is, may I ask question?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah. So we have to manually enter all the data, which actually whatever, because we have more than 15 departments. If we are taking an Excel, is there any provision to upload this data, Excel speed?
Certainly at this moment, no. My answer is no, because first thing is that you have to make sure that only innovation, entrepreneurship and IP related activities.
Voice is not coming. Deepan ji, your voice is not coming.
Hello, is it okay now?
Your voice is not coming.
Yes, now it is fine.
Yes, sir.
So what I'm saying at this moment, there is no such facility of directly exporting the data from Excel sheet to the portal. And this is for the two region we have not made it in this way, because first one is that maybe university or institution are organizing multiple activities, and out of multiple activities, maybe only few are very, very directly correlated to innovation and entrepreneurship. So in this ARIA ranking, only you have to provide that is directly and that is addressing the innovation and entrepreneurship. So don't include all the activities, whatever the institute or university is organizing. This is the first one. So maybe if institute is organized 200, maybe out of the 200 activities, only two or three or actually 20, 30 will be innovation and entrepreneurship related. So this is the way you have to first make a screening. And the second one is that why you didn't directly enable this option, because once it is will get collected from different departments, it is the nodal officer, they have to check that what are the things. It has to be cross-verified, it has to be cross-checked. And sometimes also sometimes the data in the Excel sheet that represents the data from the different sections. Like in one go, we ask the financial information also. So if you will make it directly export, auto exports to the system, then data will be not properly get into the sections properly. And that is where again the error will come. Again, you have to put additional time and extra time to again to correct it. So it is better you collect the data and you verify it and you enter it. And this is the only way, convenient way so far we have streamlined.
Okay, thank you.
Only but for financial section, because financial data may be kind of a, there will be a typo error. That's why we have made we provide one temporary login ID for the financial section to the nodal officer, so that they will give to the respective account section and they can see that what are the line items need financial value, and they can enter from the account section itself. And after that, once nodal officer will check, then they can go for final submission. So this is the additional kind of a support or kind of a adjustment, we tried our best to facilitate this data submission. Who is next? Director ABD TNAU.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Malarkudi. My question is with respect to section 6. Sir, in our university, in order to encourage entrepreneurship among the faculty members, we are giving venture capital scheme for them. So by obtaining seed funding, they are running their own venture in the university and they are supplying the, whatever they are producing to the farmers. There is some revenue generation activities are going on. But in our area, the data, so we couldn't able to file those kind of the activities.
See, when I got your point. When you are saying venture yeah. has the identity. So yeah. this time, what we understand, this is mostly in agricultural universities and other skill universities, they are running this kind of things. But actually, we insist, even though you say it is a venture, but this venture has not taken the shape of a venture, because venture always has some entity identification like SME unit. And if not SME unit, at least have some GST number, right? Because you are that involves they are dealing with commercialization or the selling of these products. So what you are suggesting, what you are saying, what I got from your point is that you definitely you are providing fund to the faculties or the units, but if they have registered as a SME unit and also have the GST number, because once you will have the SME unit registration and the GST number, you are able to able to sell the products to anybody in the market. And this is the very very primitive stage of very very preliminary stage of the venture. So this should be that this should be the starting point. And if you will have reached this stage, that definitely you can enter. And after that, startups, we are not asking SIN number, we are not asking DIN number. If you are, and but once you will say that it is a startup, then definitely you will ask the SIN number and DIN number. But if
sir, they are having GST number, they are paying GST.
Yes, if it is
but
GST,
they are not registered as a MSME sector.
Exactly. So it should be encouraged, because see, we want to make formalize all these kind of commercial activities. So definitely, if GST is there, then I think check the portal, and I think it is accepting GST number. And because this year we have thought that the committee has taken decision that many universities, those are in this stage of GST and they have MSME unit, definitely they should be allowed. And that's why we bit relaxed from startup level to the MSME and GST number this year, to enable our most of the non-technical higher education institutions and also agricultural universities and also other universities to participate in this ranking process.
Yes, sir. Even after entering the GST, we could not able to feed the data, because it is asking the registration number.
MSME, maybe I'm MSME. So please keep in mind, and next time, so the soon you will register the MSME, definitely. See, by registering MSME and GST, you have the additional benefit. Don't think that by going for a MSME registration, it's very, very less minimal cost of, I think, maximum. Because generally you can register in the district industrial centers or district industrial units. So it is better you register under the MSME unit, so that they will get additional funding, additional support system from the other government schemes also. So it is always encourage both GST registration and MSME registration.
Okay, sir. The another question I am having with respect to section 7, commercialization. So we have done a lot of commercialization, lot of technologies. But technologies are in the name of institute, university. But we don't have any IP or license number for that. If we are after feeding NA, not applicable. So the data has been feeded. My question is whether it will be taken into consideration.
I think being one of the premier agriculture university, I believe that you are trying your best to enter the information. But yes. See, for every technology transfer, either you transfer to an NGO or you transfer to a society, there should be agreement. There should be one document which will say that the terms and condition. And this terms and condition has to be recorded in the file of the institute. And if you have no license number, then at least you can give this number as a reference that this is the best, this is the license things. And if it is intellectual property based technology transfer, then definitely there should be a license agreement of royalty sharing and kind of things. And in that case, you can use also the IP registration, IP patent number also to reflect that this is a kind of a formal agreement and formal transfer. So try to formalize whatever the commercial activities you are conducting in the institute, rather doing it informal way or doing it ad hoc way. Because once it is formalized, when we say formalization, that means MSME registration or GST or having a agreement, MOU or licensing agreement or technology transfer agreement, whoever the party, whoever, even within the institute also, if you are sharing to the startup also, there should be some, or any student to adopt also. So there should be a very agreement with laid down guideline and policies that how it is going to be happen. I'm totally agree that all technology cannot be patented and intellectual property cannot be generated. But whatever the commercialization, and when I say commercialization, that means there is a commercialization which is not transferring. Commercialization means it's impact creation, or it's creating benefits at the society level in terms of the economy, like it is generating revenue, right?
Sir, we are undergoing MOU, sir, agreement with the company people. But only thing, we don't have a specific number. Maybe the file number, maybe.
File number, you can provide the file number.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Next is
Hello.
Yes, Arumugam. Kon? Who is?
Hi, I'm Priyanka.
Yes, please go ahead.
Okay, so actually I have a doubt in section 4. We only have to specify startups, those who are incubated in 1920, or we can also mention the names of those who we are supporting in 1920 also.
Those are receiving incubation support. Those have received incubation support. Those are receiving incubation support. Every now received, right? Those have received the incubation, pre-incubation support. During that financial year, it has to be entered.
Okay. Thank you.
Next.
Can I come with that details? It is section.
Yes. Please.
It is section 8 and parameter 8A. Annual budget on promoting and supporting IND activities. So now we have established this company, Section 8 company, exclusively.
It is Section 8.
In the Excel sheet, what you have provided, it is Section 8, parameter 8A.
Just wait.
Annual budget.
Okay, see, so Madam Ji, you did not to provide anything for this, because there is no specific field or section provided for this. So once you start providing this, all these sections, automatically the data captured for the expense related will come, and it will get accumulated, and that it will reflect to us what is the total expense amount, because we are going to you are going to provide expense detail for each and every section. So all these things will get accumulated, and it will the total value will reflect for that things. Similarly, when you are going to provide the revenue related information or financial values, it will come to the 8B. So there is no specific field, or there is no specific space for 8A and 8B to provide. This is the auto accumulation and summation of the financial values that you have entered in different sections.
Okay. So we can show the formation expenses of the company, and
exactly
what are the conditions we receive from corporate.
You cannot show, madam, you cannot show only in the respective sections. Like in section 1, you have to provide the what are the finances expenses you have incurred for organizing the activity, for each activity. Again, section 3, you have to provide what are the infrastructure costs you incurred for different type of incubation and pre-incubation facilities. So once you will enter for the each item or each unit, it will get accumulated, and it will come in as a one value that is called expense towards innovation entrepreneurship.
Okay, sir, I'm very clear now that 1, 3, 4, 5, 8 combination of this gives us for a parameter 8A.
the details the details part. Entered exactly the details entered in these sections will come and reflect as 8A and 8B.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. I have one thing to ask.
Okay.
Yeah, sir. I have seen in some cases in some institute they have filled the data for center of excellence. So in some cases they have also given the laboratory facility as center of excellence. Let's say I have a lab for a research. So they have provided this as center of excellence.
No, actually this is not correct. So already, if you have a center of excellence, that means it's a dedicated facility with advanced tools. It should not be adjunct lab or a kind of a lab is associated with or the part of the academic department for the regular student practical purpose. So when we say center of excellence, that means it is a center of excellence having dedicated space, facility, team, and the advanced tools and equipments that is for promoting innovation or research in the institute.
Okay, so research lab will not be a center of excellence.
Normal research labs like mechanical department research lab, this lab, this is not the to be counted. Like you have established a center of excellence that is for the electronic imaging, something like that, with funding support from the industry or government or a kind of a dedicated research unit from the institute. These things only need to be provided.
Okay.
Regular academic labs need to should not be provided, should not be entered.
Okay.
Sir, I have a question.
One by one.
Yeah, I have a question, sir.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah. I'm Professor Purnima Jain from Dialbagh Educational Institute, deemed to be University, Agra. So we have labs on land. So can that be included into the innovation or the incubation?
The lab from land. That means
lab on land. Like we have barren land, we have created number of biodiversity parks and students are putting on their research over there. They are creating number of medicinal plants over there. So can we include that into the innovation or incubation lab?
See, being the nodal officer, first you, I hope you have entered this department or the unit in the pre-qualifier section. So mostly what happened also, because this is, please note that in the pre-qualifier section and all these facilities you are entering the section 3, mostly somewhat will be correlated, because once you declare the pre-qualifier things, then you should be very careful that what are the departments you need research lab. When I say research lab, it should be a dedicated research lab. If you're saying that this is a complete dedicated lab and this lab is having focusing on generating new innovations or innovations in the area of something like agriculture, then it's your decision. You discuss with your head of the institute, and also make sure that this lab also helps and also support innovation or support students and faculties in coming up with new innovations or ideas. So because only entering is not enough, if you enter, it's fine, but it will not make use later stay in the respective other sections, then you will not use it, right? So if this department or if this lab is a dedicated one, having advanced tools and equipments and with something like a goal or objective to promote innovation and startup, then definitely you can add it. But you have to provide further details in the rest other sections in terms of how many innovations they have supported, how many startups they have generated, or any kind of funding support they provided to any student or faculty innovations or not. So these things also have to be provided. Neither this item will remain ideal and automatically machine will say that, okay, this was a redundant kind of field which was entered, but actually it has not provided any or not so involved in any kind of supports the innovation and entrepreneurship. So,
thank you, sir.
So please make sure have a detailed discussion with the head of the institute and see that how dedicated it is, what kind of interest or what kind of involvement this department is in promoting innovation. If you think that actually it is playing the role, then you can enter.
Sure, sir. Thank you very much.
Yes, next
good afternoon, sir.
yes. Hi. Please tell your name.
Sir, this is Dr. Basharat from Kashmir.
Okay.
Sir, I have a question. We have filed one patent, international patent in 2016, way back in 2016. And it is still under process, but we are not actually finding any option while we were applying for this application.
Now, if you have received any,
it's still under process.
Filing only during any old from institute side in section 8 only.
We have that.
If you have filed, then only you provide. If you have not filed, then leave it blank.
Okay, thank you, sir.
I have one more question. Like, we have two incubators and one research park. So in section 3.1, like, we don't have any student club. So where should we put in this information? In
section section 3, one is for student club. If you have no student club, you just leave it blank. And in section 3, there is a second tab that is dedicated facilities. Then there you have to enter the you have to click there. If it is a research park, then you have to provide the detail. If it is incubation unit, you have to click the incubation unit, and you have to enter two entries. You have to make two entries. One is for incubation unit 1 and second is for incubation unit 2. So this is the way you have to enter.
Okay, thank you.
And as you said that the student club is not there, so in declaration and submission phase, this student club will come red. It will appear red. So you have to confirm that that there is no information. So once you will tick the confirm, then it will enable you to submit the data.
Okay.
So the sections you are no data, you have to leave blank now. And in the declaration phase, you have to manage by ticking confirm or again visiting back to the respective section to provide the data.
Okay, thank you.
So okay, thank you then. I think it is now time off, and I will
request. Final question from Balagurunathan Periyar University.
Yes, okay, I will take two questions because Mani Madam is raising her hand or finger so many times. So I will take two questions. First is Balagurunathan, then I go to Mani.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. First of all, I would like to congratulate the innovation for ARIA for giving the separate ranking for the national institute, private institutes, and government institutions. So as like NIRF ranking, when the institution getting the ranking below 100 and below 50, they are linked with the funding opportunity rules and purse and other things. So is there is any possibility or planning for the atal ranking institutions for the for linking with the funding opportunities from the government side?
Yes.
We got fourth likely rank from the last year. We got
very likely to be very likely to be, but actually now the system is getting standardized and getting mature. So very soon this also will be linked like NIRF.
Yeah, thank you very much, sir. Because last year we got fourth rank among the Indian government institutions. So say though the all the outcomes would be go for the funding. So that's what we are asking.
See, this funding is for the identifying the potential beneficiaries. Once you will get rank 1, that doesn't mean that you will get the fund, but it will help the government and the ministries to identify the potential beneficiaries that they are likely to. So they will give some, it will help them to identify, and also they may give some preference, but it doesn't make sure that you will definitely get the fund. But definitely when you are innovative, that means you have that skill set and mindset to generate revenue from or resources from different sources. That is the competency you have. Okay, next to the Mani Madam.
Yes sir. Very good afternoon, sir. I'm Mani. I'm a finance manager from Agribusiness Incubation Center, CCS Haryana Agriculture University, sir. So we are one of the last time winners when we got the rank 3rd among all the government universities for ARIA. And we got the rank 1st among agriculture universities if we talk about on national level. So okay, so first thing, like I will just have one suggestion, maybe from the next time what we can do is like the Excel sheet that we generate, because I mean we have like different numbers of departments. And even in one department, we have like huge number of facilities, like lab facilities and everything. We have a full-fledged incubation center, which is supported by NABARD, right? So one thing that I would like to add is that why don't we like generate something like, and the Excel sheet should be like taken over only like directly to the portal, like so that we don't have to add one like each and every entry every time.
Already I have answered this to this question. And there are two difficulties. Also, there is two requirements why we have not made this arrangement. The first one is that Excel sheet is one way of facilitating the collection of the data from different sources. And what happened in the data capturing system, there are different sections. So if you will actually gone through the Excel sheet, you will see that in the section one or something, there is a data for this that will go to the section six, that is awards and recognition. Also, there is something, some field will go to the financial section. Also, there will be goes something to the non-financial section, other fields. That means what the information you will capture in the Excel sheet, it will cater into three different sections in the data capture system. And also sometimes what will happen if something wrong will capture or error will happen at the source level, maybe that same error will continue to the last final submission stage. So to make sure that nodal officer will go through each page and they will make sure that whatever the data provided by the departments are actually as per the alignment with the requirement. And also they will make sure that the financial value is correct and also validated by the financial section. So it need lots of things to be cross-checked to reduce the error. And if you make it direct thing, what will happen? Many, no doubt, good institute, they will do all this due diligence. But many institutions, they simply directly export and the error will continue. Then the headache, the whole pressure will on comes to the Ministry of Education to check, and finally the system will not able to sustain. So to make this sustainment, to bring this sustaining things, and we make sure that it has to be this thing. But definitely we enable this temporary login ID for financial data. Then this Excel sheet also we provided this video guides. Also we're conducting this kind of orientation sessions. And also recently we started this Telegram group to facilitate this process of data collection and data submission. I hope most of you have got some clarity on data submission portal and how this portal is to be utilized, and also data submission to be done before 8th of March. So please don't wait for the last moment. If you have not completed this pre-qualifier section, please complete it and mobilize the data collection process and speed up the data collection process and submit in the ARIA DCS before 8th of March. So thank you again, and for joining the session and also actively participating in this ARIA 2021 ranking. And we believe that definitely when the result will be announced, you all will get some better result and better rank compared to the last year. Thank you again.